الله أكبر الله أكبر.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم.
يا أيها الذين آمنوا إذا نودي للصلاة من يوم الجمعة فاسعوا إلى ذكر الله وذروا البيع، ذلكم خير لكم إن كنتم تعلمون.
الحمد لله، نحمده ونستعينه ونستهديه، ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له، ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله وصفيه من خلقه وخليله. أما بعد، أيها الإخوة الكرام، يقول الله سبحانه وتعالى: ويا قوم أوفوا المكيال والميزان بالقسط، ولا تبخسوا الناس أشياءهم، ولا تعثوا في الأرض مفسدين. الله سبحانه وتعالى عرس سد: ويل للمطففين الذين إذا اكتالوا على الناس يستوفون، وإذا كالوهم أو وزنوهم يخسرون، ألا يظن أولئك أنهم مبعوثون ليوم عظيم يوم يقوم الناس لرب العالمين. In these ayat, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala clearly stated, without any doubt, that we have to be fair and honest when we do business and transaction. And when we major things, we have to major it fairly. If we major it for others, or for ourselves. We should not, when we major things for ourselves, try to major more. And when we major for others, we major less. And this is applied to all types of businesses and transactions. The products and services, even knowledge. If somebody supposed to submit a document with certain quality and certain quantity, and include certain items or information or topics, then this person should do it properly and should do it according to the contract, and should not submit this document less information or less quality, or there's certain things missing. This is also included. Same like 1 kilogram sugar, same like how much you sell the person, or how much meat in the pizza. So they are all the same concept. The concept is really of honesty and sincerity when you sell and buy from people. To be fair and to be honest and to follow that contract. Brothers in Islam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala called this corruption. So if the person doesn't do that, major things properly, that means this is corruption. If the person give the milk, half of it water, as milk, this is corruption. He should say 50% of it water. Otherwise, he should not claim that this is 100% milk. And this principle can be applied to all the services and products. Brothers in Islam, at-taqwa is very central issue in business. Their consciousness, the person, because certain things sometimes no one knows, except the person himself, who's aware, he's aware or she's aware of the details, because the person expert in that area. So maybe the buyer will not understand, will not know, because business based on trust as well. So if people trust you to do certain things or deliver certain services or product, you need to be honest with that and fulfill the quality and quantity that you as expert know that's supposed to be there. Brothers in Islam, وَمَنْ يَتَّقِ اللَّهَ يَجْعَلْ لَهُ مَخْرَجًا وَيَرْزُقْهُ مِنْ حَيْثُ لَا يَحْتَسِبْ. And this is a rule in the Quran, this ayah, applied to all aspects of the life. But in this context, the person who fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and he is fair with others and honest with others, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will make it easy for him. Allah will give him the barakah, the success and a blessing. And the person will make even more money with the honesty. Brothers in Islam, we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us among those one who are honest and sincere. Amen. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam, he said, Ya ma'ashar al-muhajirin, all people who migrated to Medina. So he's talking to the muhajirin, people of Mecca who went to Medina for the sake of building the Islamic society in Medina. خَمْسٌ إِذَا ابْتُلِيتُمْ بِهِنَّ وَأَعُوذُ بِاللَّهِ أَن تُدْرِكُوهُنَّ. Five things I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala not to see it in your life and not to experience it. And it is really great musibah. It's a very great bad things to have in the life or to experience. And he said, I seek refuge in Allah from them. وَذَكَرَ مِنْهَا. And he said, one of them, وَلَمْ يَنْقُصُوا الْمِكْيَالَ وَالْمِيزَانِ إِلَّا أُخِذُوا بِالسِّنِينَ وَشِدَّةَ الْمَؤُونَةِ وَجَوْرِ السُّلْطَانِ عَلَيْهِمْ. This hadith that narrated by Al-Albani عند Ibn Majah وغيره, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, when they play with the measurements, when they play with the measurements, when they are honest in quantity and quality in their business, with the scale as well, then what happened? They will be poor and they will feel poor and remain poor. Meaning they will never be happy and satisfied. The happiness, the real happiness will not come to them. They will not feel that they are rich enough and they will keep poor in their heart and in their mind. And actually they will have many distractions and things that repairing cars, repairing damages, health problem, miserable life they will have because they are playing with these measurements. Brothers in Islam, also, Allah will send leaders to them that they are zalimeen. Zalimeen, oppressors, those leaders that Allah will send them as punishment for them because they are not honest and sincere in their measurements and in their business. From the last khutbah, we learned that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, التاجر الأمين الصدوق مع النبيين والصديقين والشهداء. And this is referring to the Yawm al-Qiyamah in the Jannah, that the honest and sincere trader or businessman or contractor or even a student as contractor with the university. A student as contractor with the university, the employee is contractor and is a trader because he deliver service or deliver certain products or deliver certain time that he needs to give. So this is all come under the same category. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said they will be, because they are honest, they will be with the prophets and messengers and companions of the prophets and messengers salawatullahi wa salamu alayhim ajma'in and the shuhada on the day of judgment, because they were honest and sincere. Brothers in Islam, this has to also, we have to consider the culture. The culture meaning the, for example, if somebody comes late for a meeting or conference, 2-3 minutes, culturally accepted. But if somebody late half an hour, this is not accepted. So it doesn't mean that if the person delivering something almost perfect, that means this part of this person money is haram. No, this person has to try his best. This person has to be honest and sincere. And if this person has faults or errors or mistakes, these are rectified if they are not consistent. And if the person is always trying to improve the service and deliver it as best as he can or she can. Brothers in Islam, this is very, very important. For example, if culturally it's accepted that the person used the telephone of his office for a certain emergency time or, for example, important issues, and he phoned maybe for a minute or two or even 5 minutes, if it is accepted as culture within the company, or this is fine. If the person, for example, printing one page for his personal use, and he is using the printer in his office, and this is culturally accepted, this is fine. But if the person is printing 100 pages, even if this 100 pages is from the Quran or the timetable of the prayer, this will not be accepted because culturally not accepted. Because this affects the business. If the person getting 2-3 minutes talking to somebody for something very important or urgent, arranging an appointment with a doctor, something like this, it's fine. But if the person is spending half an hour just looking at BBC, and in another half an hour looking at Al Jazeera, and another half an hour another channel, or Facebook, or why he's supposed to be working, that is not accepted in the business and in the culture. Brothers in Islam, the main thing is the contract and the conditions of this contract, and what is accepted, and the person needs to apply that sincerely and earnestly. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, لا ضرر ولا ضرار. لا ضرر ولا ضرار. Meaning that the person should not be harmed, and also he should not cause harms for others. And this principle is general, but also applied in business. And the sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam, and this hadith, very, very, very interesting. See? The hadith said that the tujjar مع الأنبياء ومع النبيين مع الصديقين مع الشهداء, that's the honest tajir, the honest trader. Look, if the trader is not honest, what the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, إن التجار هم الفجار. إن التجار هم الفجار. They are really oppressors. They are actually breaking the laws of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They are sinful. And when the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم asked, قيل يا رسول الله أوليس أحل الله البيع, is it not true that Allah made the business and trade is halal for us? So why they are fujjar? The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, بلى ولكنهم يحدثون فيكذبون ويحلفون ويأثمون. Because they, when they speak, they argue a lot, they discuss things, they swear, they make qasam, and they lie. They lie. They say this is a so-and-so brand, and it's not. They say this is so-and-so quality, and it is not. So while they are trying to market their products and services, they are trying to promote it, they are not honest. They exaggerate to the extent that they lie. They give false facts. And this is why they are fujjar. Brothers in Islam, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam, in this context, he said, المكر والخديعة في النار. المكر والخديعة في النار. The false plotting and the deceiving people and cheating people in the business is to the hellfire. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will not accept that. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves the person to love for the buyers as he loves for himself. And to take his money with happiness from his heart that he did well and he did his job properly. Brothers in Islam, the markets and shop centers and malls and all this, there's something interesting that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam mentioned about akhir al-zaman. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "La taqum al-sa'a hatta tadhhar al-fitan." At the end of the time, when the qiyamah very close, there will be lots of fitan, lots of trials, and lots of difficulties and struggle. وَيَكْثُرُ الْكَذِبُ, and the lie will be common. The lie will be common among people. وَتَتَقَارَبِ الْأَسْوَاقِ, تَتَقَارَبِ الْأَسْوَاقِ, and the shops will be close to each other. And many of the tafsir about it, you see lots of shops, they sell the same thing and they are beside each other. It used to be, but now is more and more and more. You'll find even identical shops and they all sell the same thing in the same street. Brothers in Islam, also online, you see many websites, you just go to Google, you want to buy something online. You see hundreds of online websites, they sell the same things and same products. Different prices, different qualities, different descriptions. وَيَكْتُرُ الْهَرْجِ, and lots of harsh will be common as well. And when the Prophet ﷺ was asked, وَمَا الْهَرْجِ? قَالْ الْقَتِلِ. قَالْ lots of killing, lots of crimes. We heard what happened in Belgium just the other day. Lots of violence, lots of killing without justification that happened. And this is sign from the last day, the end of the time. Brothers in Islam, we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us among those people who promote the peace and honesty and sincerity. أقول ما تسمعون واستغفر الله لي ولكم فيا فوز المستغفرين. إن الحمد لله نحمده ونصلي ونسلم على رسول الله وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله وبعد أيها الإخوة النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم said الحلف منفقة للسلعة ممحقة للبركة when this way they make qasam about their products maybe this will make things easier for them to sell but this will actually destroy the barakah, the blessing of their income. And if this is haram, this is of course from the big sins in Islam. استعينوا على قضاء حوائجكم بالسر والكتمان فإن كل ذي نعمة محسول. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, when you do things, business transaction, you do contracts, you make it also quietly. Don't just tell everyone, unless those one who are involved. Because everyone who has ni'mah, has bounty, is mahsood. People might feel jealous about it. So this is one of the principles in business, that we should not show everything that we do, and we should show only those people who are concerned about it, the concerned parties. So if somebody signed any transaction, buy a house, he should not like, put it in Facebook, look at my new house, look at this. Some people, they don't have it. If somebody got a new shop, he just promoted. So we can tell people, but in a very sensible and wise way. Not just show off, and then this will bring more hasad, more jealousy, and problems to us. Brothers in Islam, I was told last week after the khutbah by two people, they came and they said, really, they regret. They said they were working in a certain place in this city. And they say when the boss there, he look at them when the customer comes and they have to say that the meat is halal. They have to say that this meat is halal. But they know it is not halal and they know it's haram. And they say because the boss there, so we have to say it is halal. But then when the boss is not there, and a customer comes or somebody that they know, they tell, don't buy from here, it is not halal. So, and they realized after the khutbah that if the person get his income with lie, this is haram income. We have to be honest, we have to fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, not people. We have to fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, not people. And we should be honest in the products, the description of the products, and what we have when we sell things in the market. Brothers in Islam, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam, he said, إِنَّ مِنَ النَّاسِ نَاسًا مَفَاتِيحَ لِلْخَيْرِ مَغَالِيقَ لِلْشَرِّ وَإِنَّ مِنَ النَّاسِ نَاسًا مَفَاتِيحَ لِلْشَرِّ مَغَالِيقَ لِلْخَيْرِ فَطُوبَى لِمَنْ جَعَلَ اللَّهُ مَفَاتِيحَ الْخَيْرِ وَجَعَلَ اللَّهُ مَفَاتِيحَ الْخَيْرِ عَلَى يَدَيْهِ وَوَيْلٌ لِمَنْ جَعَلَ اللَّهُ مَفَاتِيحَ الشَّرِّ عَلَى يَدَيْهِ. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, some people, they open doors of goods and khair for others, and they close the doors of shar. And some people, they open the doors of evil for others, and they close the door, the good doors and door of khair for others. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, special position in paradise for those one who open goodness for others and khair for others, and they close the doors of evil. Brothers in Islam, like I give you one example. The person who sell alcohol, this is not opening door of khayr. This is opening door of evil and shar. Muslims and non-Muslim. We should not promote it for even non-Muslim. We should have in our heart that we should love for them the hidayah and goodness as we love it for ourselves. And we should not sell it for non-Muslim with any excuse because it's not allowed in Islam. Selling alcohol to non-Muslim or selling it to Muslim is the same. And the person who sells alcohol, his income is not halal. Or at least part of his income not halal. Which means his income is mixed. And if he eats, he doesn't know whether he eats from the halal or haram. And his children, when they eat, he doesn't know from which part they eat. Because people, when they pay in the restaurant, they pay for the whole meal, including alcohol. That means when they give the person, for example, 30 pounds, this 30 pounds, part of it from alcohol. When he put this 30 pounds with the accountancy, he cannot separate them. Some people say, I will separate this, I will put this account different from that. Why we do this? Why we do the kabira from the kabar and make Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala curse us and curse people with us and people around us and people who are dealing with us with this alcohol? And it's haram. So we need to clear ourselves and help each other to get out of all these muharramat. And we should not make one day halal, one day haram, because this is also not right. Or 1 hour halal and 1 hour haram. Or some people, they say, I do not sell alcohol, but I have license, people can bring their alcohol with them. Accommodating alcohol is as haram as selling alcohol in Islam. As the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam cursed those people who sell, those people who buy, those people who carry it, those people who witness it, those people who sign the contract, those people who exquisite it or serve it. So all those people are cursed. Why we need to be cursed? And our family and our children and suffer in our lives and then cry to Allah and make dua that Allah remove the difficulties from us. And the reason is actually ourselves. Brothers in Islam, we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to guide all of us to the straight path and make us among those people who follow Islam sincerely for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They trust that Allah is ar-Razzaq, Allah is the provider and no one else. At the end of my khutbah, I would like to pray for all the victims in Belgium, Muslim and non-Muslim, and their families, the injured one, to give them the shifa and hidayah. And as we like for ourselves, we should like for them. We should like for them that Allah remove all the suffering from their families. Allah give them the hidayah, the guidance to be in the straight path. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to remove all the pain and suffering for all the parents, all the injured one, to have the cure and health back. Amen. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala also to bring the justice against all the criminals and the crimes and the criminals who actually spread the conflict and more problems in the communities. And we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to spread the peace and tranquility in Muslim countries and non-Muslim countries and make harmony and good relation between all the human in the world. Wa sallallahu ala sayyidina Muhammad walhamdulillahi rabbil alamin.